Blessed. If I say I am blessed, you need also to say you are also blessed. I am blessed. I'm also blessed. Yeah, you know, we blessing is in our DNA. Blessings are in our DNA. It's like we are born of blessings. Can you say I am born of blessings? Or can you say I am a blessing? I am a blessing. I am. Can you say I am a blessing? When you got born again is when you are made a blessing. Pastor Chris inspires me a lot. He says, I was born for the cries of many people. Yes, I was born to become an answer to the problems of so many people. And the truth is, by the virtue of just being born again, by just accepting Jesus, we have been added to a family that knows no failure, that knows no poverty. Today, I am beginning a topic in this main service. I think people should be here, some people here. Want to be very rich. You want to be very rich? I warn you, just here, for the next 1 month, I always speaking about how to be very rich. How to, you know, we took on a thousand zinyinge kumfuko, sio? I want now to see those millions becoming like thousands. It's only that we are not in Zimbabwe where they can print that kind of money, or in Uganda. You know, in Uganda you can have 200,000 moja tu imesi noti moja unapewa 200,000 and like So I want to look at 1 million note. It is not there in Kenya, but as piling it vile una fold hiyo 1,000 1,000 1,000, you know, fold 1 million 1 million 1 million. I know you don't want that kind of talk. Praise the Lord. This is the year of money. Praise the Lord. This is the year of money. So God wants to bless us so much so that we can easily do things that looks very hard. Look very hard. There is always an anointing that accompanies the teaching of the word. As the word comes, the word transmits whatever we need in our lives. And we'll expose the scriptures in Jesus' name. Now, we've been continuing in revival. Might be want to ask you a question. Do you think what is beginning here is already beginning a revival in Marsabit? Are you sensing anything? You know, if you are collecting church leaders sitting down and training them, if we are reaching all the schools around the young generation, if we are going on radio, and we don't struggle to do it, if you're doing all these things just naturally, I don't know if you're aware of what is happening. And the truth is, many people don't understand the move of God. It becomes very challenging. I don't know how you are. TBS was yesterday. Sisi unajua inabidi tu watu waende tu kwingine wajipange. Tukikaa hapa kutoka ni ngumu. Tunaweza kaa hata masaa manne just talking. We realized that the two scriptures we read, chapter number 4 of Hebrews and chapter number 1 of the book of Joshua, and even 1 Peter chapter number 2 verse 2, I think, chapter 2 verse 2. We realized that what God was trying to say in those three scriptures is, do not allow anybody to remove you from the word. Do not allow anybody. Because when we are removed out of the word, God was telling Joshua, you want a good success? Because there's also bad success. Just meditate on this word. day and night. Do not turn. And we were defining yesterday, what is turning from, to the left or to the right? We realize that turning to the right or is simply hearing somebody's voice that takes you away from the voice of God. Even in chapter number 4, the Bible says of Hebrews, the reason as to why they didn't get into the arrest or they didn't enter Canaan is because simply they didn't mix the word they received with faith. In other words, the 10 spies brought their things. They received it. Instead of receiving the promise of God, they received the message of the 10 spies who believed they could not. And they... Whenever any other information comes into your life, which is outside the word of God, you begin dying. Or let me put it this way, God lives your life. You know, when God is there, there has to be life. When God is there. And the easiest way to have God in you is to have faith that cannot waver, stagger. Use wave faith, faith that... You know, if he said, he said it. So don't tell me anything else. If he's God, he's period. I don't want to hear anything else. He said it. Now, when you take God at his word like that, he comes the way he is. I wish sometimes he puts on human flesh. You know, sometimes we just want to see him physically. That's the only challenge we have. He doesn't. He just lands. And revival is not an option. It is a must. It is a must. So we are for the revival of the Marsabit County at this time. I will give you a book and put on our discipleship page. I want you to read. There are guys who are in their mid-20s who began revival in 1904. They were in mid-20s. There's a guy called Evans Robert. That man, that guy, very young. He brought heaven like this. You know, I don't know how can I put it? It's like, I don't know how he, you know, he came to and you ended up a kashusha. He brought it down. And some old people who are also believers then, they felt like this move of God is so heavy here. These young people cannot manage. Are we very young? You think we are very young? Yes, many who look at us are very young because they have some gray hair somewhere. And then they might look like, you see, and then these people say, these people might mess up. And the move of God for those people who have been at that point, at that time, I think we need to read such things. Let's read materials on revivals. Because before Jesus comes, we revive Marsabit and go away. We revive this land. And those big people like, and then they realized the Holy Spirit was in charge. And they could not do anything else. That revival, what it did. For them that have understanding of it until today. Kuna wale wameishi mpaka leo. Na revival ilikuwa 1904. Today is how much? How many years down the line? And the people are still alive and they can talk of it until today. That's why sometimes we need to live long, eh? So that we tell people what happened some 100 years ago. Even sometimes you describe, they cannot understand it. Marsabit is being revived. Praise the Lord. Marsabit is being revived. Every time revival comes, the message comes. When God sends a message, a new message that has never been in the environment, it means revival has arrived. And God always revives a place by sending a man. Always look at the whole Bible. When things have gone bad, have fallen apart, he raises a man. And when the man begins declaring some oracles of God, what happens? Revival. Revival that goes for 40 years, 50 years in the Old Testament. Revival. So what we are accessing here is what will revive Marsabit County in a big way. And if I talk about Marsabit County, I am including the four constituencies. Is that word still functional? Those four constituencies, Les Amis, Saku, Lothor, and Moyale. You see, when God begins doing things, it doesn't work. You wonder how it goes. Just that we were discussing here. You know, there's a lot of revelations. One man was just sitting and looking at us. He didn't speak anything. He just said, God, when will you bring me to this level of faith? That's Dennis. We're just watching some of us talk here. Like, wow. Just anangalia huyu yakimaliza akianza kuongea, you know, the two of us talking, he just like, hey God, when will you raise me to this kind of this fate? When am I going to talk? Today is coming with his fiancé here. They have decided to join here from Catholic here, in the name of Jesus. It's called revival. I mean revival. Even people who have messed up are finding themselves here. Revival. God, can you say God is using me to revive this land? You don't need so many people. In that revival, they realize there are very few. But then they made the move of God too heavy. A point nobody could not go and notice. You know, when God comes down, even Muslims will know. They must begin speaking about us. I think, you know, if God is doing something, they have to speak. They have to speak out. We are also reviving people in the area of finance. You think revival is only raising people to pray? Even financial revival. Financial revival. If your finances has been dying down, we can resurrect it. We can bring it up. Revival carries everything. Revival. Why? Revival. How do you put about it? You know you are like putting life in everything that has been dying. You cause it to come alive. Life is what has been put in us. I'm saying life. Today I was to speak about Holy Spirit as the agent of, or how do I put it? Holy Spirit is the engine behind the revival. If you remove an engine from a vehicle, what do you have? A container without a content. Can I put it that way? Ipikipiki, ondoa tu yo. Yo engine hapo. Na tuone kama utaendesha. Utakaa tu. And there's a way there's something you do to that bike so that it always revive. What do you do it? Fuel. There's something you put inside. Let's look at chapter number 1 of Acts verse 8. Holy Spirit, hallelujah. I'm reading amplified version. It is indeed amplified. The Bible says, but you shall receive power, ability, efficiency, and might when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and shall be my witnesses in Jerusalem and in all Judea and Samaria and to the ends, the very bounds of the earth. One problem with religion is that it doesn't understand Holy Spirit. You know, I've seen people who talk Holy Spirit leaders, Holy Spirit, and the truth is they're always outside the, in the will of God. You know, when Holy Spirit becomes a mystery to you, you're in trouble. You're not living life. Holy Spirit must become a good friend of you. He's a person. Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit. My goodness. Think about Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit. I don't know what you hear when I say Holy Spirit. Because some of us, it's like he's our engine. He's the engine of this ministry. You see, when you put him on, you can move wherever. You can move to the farthest that you want. The snow, hii motorbike unajua, kama ingekuwa na uwezo wa kuingia ndani ya hii kitu, hata ukienda, yeye inaenda tu. Inaweza ingia hata kwa hii mabati ipite. It doesn't want to know whether there is a obstacle or anything called engine. Ni wetu ndio na direct. In other words, it doesn't know obstacle. When the Holy Spirit is so much in charge of our lives, I mean so much, our progress is inevitable. Our progress is inevitable. Now this word power, they've given us some three words there: ability, efficiency, and might. Ability, efficiency, that's how this King James Version describes. But the word power is from a Greek word, dunamis. Now that word dunamis, there's a way, I think it's good to study Greek. It's only that Jesus is coming very fast, so when will I begin and finish? That's the challenge. Now for now, I'll just be studying words, like this kind of word, because if I begin studying it, I might find myself in heaven and I might not use it. But I think the word dunamis was taken from a word that means dynamo. You know what dynamo is? Might be a good understanding of dynamo is generator. You know generator, what do you do to generator? You pull just once and it continues producing. In a generate, you know there's a way it propels itself to do more. So this word power, what it means is this: when the Holy Spirit comes upon you, they are simply telling us that there is power that generates itself in us. How can I put it? There is power that can be generated within us. This, in other words, there's a generator in us that can generate that power. In other words, that power I can have anytime I want. All I need to do is just to pull it. Like what you do there. You pull it na unaachilia. Kama fuel iko ndani na fuel yaini nini? Fuel yaini neno. You know, the more the word enters you, and then you begin roaring. You revive yourself first. You revive yourself before you go and revive others. You put more fire on your inside. So that when you stand, people just have to hear. By the end of this year, I'll be operating by the anointing upon Pastor Lai. That one is so clear. So clear to me. I mean so clear. That man has revived. The other day I was listening to him, and he said, we have already taken over Mombasa spiritually. Because the number of believers are more than the number of non-believers in that town. Now he says, we are taking over finances, the wealth of that land. You see where it begins? It begins from a spiritual. If we are dead spiritually, we cannot be in charge even financially. We cannot be in charge. A man can say this, alangalia tu pale pale. Can we turn that place into a church? What do you think? Where the church at Likoni is, the JCC was a big bar. Bar kubwa yenye watu walikuwa kienda. He says, I am turning this thing into. And people are laughing. In fact, when the owners of that place heard, they laughed at him. But they got born again and they gave it. And it's a church now. It's called revival. You are even reviving buildings. imagine reviving. You know, when he was saying that, I realized buying this one is too small, too light then. If he could buy a whole land that is seated on by a bar and turn to a church, what about this empty one? We just pick it and go. Praise the Lord. Revival. When the Holy Spirit is inside you. You see, that power that generates itself. When we speak in tongues, that is when we are generating energy. And if you speak in tongues for 1 hour, for 2 hours, and you stand up, your mind has been taken over by God. You're not the one who's in charge. You are as good as a drunkard. You know a drunkard? Who has filled his stomach. Is it his stomach or how did it go into the brain? And it began affecting his, he put it in the stomach, but the thing is affecting the brain. So when he comes out now, he can't talk anything. This power that we receive when the Holy Spirit comes upon you, that Jesus said, he says when the Holy Spirit comes upon you, this power that you receive, this is the power that begins by reviving you and reviving others around you. So the more you talk in tongues, how many hours do you speak in tongues in a day? Or how many hours do you revive yourself? You know, when you speak in tongues, you displace yourself and you place God in yourself. And he takes over and he moves on. Then you can revive anything by that time. When this power comes upon you, there will be no barrier that can stop you. That's what he means here. You shall be my witnesses in Jerusalem. You see, Jerusalem is the most difficult place to testify about Jesus. But they'll begin from there. The work they began there will go into Judea, Samaria, and to the ends of the earth. In other words, the more you generate, the more you're removing barriers. The more you're removing barriers. Even when people are sitting and praying against you, like what has been happening to them. How many times have they been praying against them? The more these people plan against them, the more they put themselves in prayer and speak in tongues. So imagine this. How do we finish these people? How do we stop these people? That's the language of the Pharisees at that time. But then they're saying, they're coming into the house of God and they're praying. They're generating more power inside here. These other ones are not generating power. Those are just human talks. Insecure people, failures talking out there. But you're coming inside and you are, how do you call it? You are availing more power to yourself. In fact, the more they're sitting there, the more you're becoming dangerous for them. The more dangerous you become, the more so the day you come out, they just have to surrender. You see, you reach somebody and somebody has invited them and said, please, you might be fighting God. Stop it. I wish we know how to use this power of the Spirit. That's why you see the Bible promises self progress from glory to glory. In other words, we should not be less than what we were yesterday. We should not be less. We should not be less. We should be more. I should be more. In fact, the more I activate the power of the Holy Spirit in me, the more I should become more. The more I should possess more things. The more. This is, can it really be called revival? You know, revival is something that somebody anaku. This when a vehicle mekata ku move, what happens? You try to push it or jump start. Not revival is something like that. And what we have is more than revival. Inside yetu na battery yako. Let me just jump start mine. Am my pikipiki See a so-so. In Jesus' name, a new one is coming. You don't need this bike that always looks for revival. You don't have to be revived. I think we need to have K. You don't even know. Ah. That is the one that is revival by itself. It just moves. So you don't need to be jump started. No, I don't need to be jump started. Mimi. Ah, me, I know. These guys were saying yesterday. I went to speak. He says, you know, when you go to Nairobi, you know. Listen, these neighbors. They said, when you go to Nairobi, we know. We didn't hear you for some. Because they know when I enter here, I explode. And nasijui kuna kwanga na anointing gani asubuhi. Kuna vile unaongea. Si kama saa hizi vile tunaongea. Satisa, kuna vile tu inatoka. And you just see the area is in trouble. And they know. They ask me, eh, Pastor, najua ulienda. Kama huku hapa. Yodhi pikipiki, hao wengine wanakuja saa kumi na moja. Now you here, enter here. Yes. And themselves, they are testifying the progress of this work. You cannot be speaking in tongues and speak victim language. You see, when the Holy Spirit comes, He does something to your spirit. To your spirit. And whatever He puts in your spirit, nothing can stand against it. Whatever, I'm saying whatever. And let me make this statement. You see, the Holy Spirit is not only used for ministry. It's not used only for ministry. It can be used for anything. I mean any work you are doing. He can put in you as you're speaking an idea about a business, about you what, whatever you are involved in, that the surrounding cannot withstand. Power. They should have used the word superpower here. Because no power can be compared to this power. This power. No power. Many a times when God arrives in an environment, many people don't see. Imagine if Jesus himself, they have been waiting for him all the years, and he arrived, they could not recognize. Only the people who have been moving by the Spirit, those are the only one who recognized. If Simeon can know someone of 8 years, 8 days, and he says this is the Holy Spirit. So this thing, you see, we must move boundaries, beyond boundaries. Lazima tuingie Bubisa. My corner. Northor. We have to move boundaries. Then to rudi side pia hivi. Karare. Logo. You know, he says, if the power comes in you, he says, you will move. You know, sit somewhere. There's this movement. So this revival we take everywhere. We take to every town in Marsabit County. This revival. This revival. We take everywhere. I'm saying everywhere. Holy Spirit, I'm saying, is the engine behind any revival that happens. And if you only know how to work with Him, if we only know how to work with Him, you see, you realize that now, if somebody does not understand the mind of God, this is nothing called revival. How can you be having God every day in your service and still feel dry? How, you know, it's surprising. So Now, it also means revival only happens for people who are spiritually mature. Those are the ones who causes revival. They cause. There should be revival. When revival happens, new ideas is deposited in our thoughts and minds by God. You don't think the same way. You know, the kind of prayer we make every morning is very powerful. I don't know you, but you see, many times I receive instruction about what I am to do next in the mornings when I pray. And if that thing, like if you see, speaking in tongues for 1 hour or 2 hours without putting any other words, these are the languages we use, that looks a bit very unholy. When you put that, and you see, there's something that remains inside you by the time you finish speaking. And God has already communicated. God does not communicate in what? He communicates to your spirit. The spirit is inside. So when he settles something inside there, then you know that this is what I'm to do. And if it has settled in this heart, that has already happened. So you move and tweet. As long as you are picking new idea from him every day. I'm saying every day. Not someday. That's why prayer should not be something that you do when you want something from God. And even what you want is material things. I want fees. See, I want healing. I want... No. Prayer should deposit some internal things in your heart that will turn your life around forever. You know, there's something it can deposit in. That's why I think we should not be tired of praying. Now, if you've been praying for 1 hour, I think you need to improve. 5 to 6 is not bad. But you can pray from the house. I don't know what you'll do it. For me, you tell me come 5 here. It's as good as I've not prayed. Even the 1 of 4 looks to me like I have not prayed. So by the time you people here enter here at 5, you know me, I'm already somewhere. So if there's a day I came here at 2:50. Hey, I prayed in tongues for 2 hours. I don't know why I didn't do the following day. I came at 3:50. The more time you add, the more glorious you become. If 1 hour he has been metamorphosing you, what if it becomes 2 hours? 3 hours? How do they spend the whole night in prayer? The whole night. Like lie, sleeps only 2 hours. You wakati wa Sunday. Usiku wa Sunday. 2 hours only. And his biggest percentage of prayer, the language he uses in prayer is tongues. So by the time he stands there in the morning, the whole day stands speaking. It's like the man came down from heaven, not from there. Tongues, speaking in tongues. Irrespective of how small time he has to speak to people, he prays for 2 hours in tongues. Now, that is how he revives himself. Imagine he has been preaching 40 years. When he was 25 years is when he began preaching. Now he's 65 years old. That man. But he looks like a young man still. You don't even see. How can that spirit be inside you and you go old? How? The more you speak... You know, Holy Spirit is the oxygen that people are taking in heaven. Are you aware of that? And there is no aging. There is no aging. He can control even, what is it called? your physical strength. So the more you revive yourself, what we need now is reviving ourselves. More than anything else, work on yourself. You know, people who don't work on themselves, they will expire early. You can expire while you're young. You can expire while you're young. If you do not improve yourself, I've realized the power of knowledge. Kuna ujinga nyingi bwana ingefaa kuondolewa nyingi sana. Hey, nyingi. Ayayaya. So many foolishness imejaa kwa kichwa. When you think that you have already arrived, you're the biggest fool in the world. I'm telling you the truth. when you don't look for more information to improve yourself, you are already a fool. That should just inform you. You're not wise. Every time unakuja kwa class, unashangaa kama wewe unajua chochote. Like when I went for this class last week. Is it last week? Yeah. And I'm like, nimewahi soma hii kitabu ya ACT. Ndio wanachambua, wanakuonyesha vitu wenye hujawahi ona. They were talking about church growth. And they are showing us how the church grew from Jerusalem and spread all over. I'm like, wow, have I ever read this Bible? This very book of Acts that we don't read. There's a way they do it, and then you see. You know, if something is becoming, has been growing over a period of years, I think we should take interest, especially now, for some of us who are doing ministry. Why did this man, until today, still moving? And, you know, now he is doing a lot of church planting in Europe, in US, in Australia. Him. In vile tu corona ilikatiza, they were doing a lot of church planting everywhere, and they're taking people from Mombasa and stationing there. Na sisi tunatulia tu kwa hii room ndogo hapa 20, 30, 40, 50 years na tumefika, and people are taking the whole world. What is this? I ask myself, what is this that makes JCC? And I've now realized what makes them what they are. It is knowledge and the ability to flow with the Holy Spirit. It's simple that. If I talk about knowledge, I'm talking about revelation knowledge and how to flow with the Spirit. That's why any ministry that comes under them is revived. It's revived. So if I revive myself by taking in the word, and the biggest agent of revival in me first is the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is the one who will guide me even in understanding the truth. Hii inabaki tu scriptures. Hii zenye tunasoma. Scriptures, the word scripture means writings. Something that somebody wrote. That's what scriptures means. So it remains scriptures. Jesus was telling them, you are turning the scriptures upside down and you're looking for eternal life. But the scriptures talks about who? Moses talked about me. Isaiah talked about me. Jeremiah talked about me. You see, those are called scriptures, writings of somebody. You are reading it, but you are not finding me. You have not seen me. You cannot access me. These remain scriptures until the Holy Spirit opens up your eyes. And then it becomes a reality. In this place, or in this church, one of the things that I am praying God to do is to make the Bible reality in Marsabit. It's not just about reading, preaching. Leo tu watu wata preach. I wish tungechukuliwa picha ya wote wenye walikuwa wakipreach na kila kitu wenye wana preach. Everybody will be preaching, all this church. But who will be releasing light or life?
You see, when the Holy Spirit inspires you, I was asking myself, really, they call it school of impartation, the JCC one. And I'm like, and then they say, this other one is this school lengine ni ya kwenda kuchukua academic knowledge. They even call it academic in nature. But then this one they call school of impartation. And I realized the difference. The difference is that the lecturers in this school that we are doing, they're all of them ministers in the church. And they are speaking in tongues at least 2 hours every morning, studying the scriptures so much. And then a man or a woman who has been so filled with the Holy Spirit is standing before you to speak to you. Compare this one to other schools. That lecturer just wake up from anywhere, whatever time, and he just comes and he stands there. These people are walking with God every day of their life. They're experiencing God in a big way. They stand before you. You see, when I'm loaded with the Holy Spirit and I stand here, I'm not just talking. These are just talks. Something will enter your spirit from here, and your life will never be the same. Changes must happen. You know, you don't just choose. You don't choose what to be when you come and sit under an anointed man of God. You don't choose. He's the one who will choose what you will be. What can I put in there? And then when they hit you, they know some change is happening. So you see, revival is easy when you are always stirring yourself up. Look at this, the book of Ephesians, chapter number 5, verse 18. Let me begin from verse 17, because I think that is where we sometimes make a lot of mistakes. The Bible says, therefore, do not be vague and thoughtless and foolish, but understanding and firmly grasping what the will of the Lord is. In other words, it says you are a fool if you don't know the will of God. That's what it means. Sindio. If you don't know the will of God, you are a fool. My goodness. And do not get drunk with wine, for that is debauchery. But ever be filled and stimulated with the Holy Spirit. Hey. What does it mean to be stimulated? Other version says, be drunk. Yeah. Stimulated. Stimulated. Be drunk. Speaking out to one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, offering praises with voices and instruments, and making melody with all your heart to the Lord. At all times and for everything, giving thanks in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ to God the Father. In other words, if you don't know the will of God, you cannot get maximum benefit from the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit and ignorance cannot work together. Eh? If you have the Holy Spirit, you must have enough knowledge. Enough working knowledge. If you don't have working knowledge, you are a fool. And the Holy Spirit cannot be a friend of a fool. You know, if you get drunk and you don't know what to speak, that's dangerous. Have you seen some people who are speaking tongues so much and they don't have the word in them? They go around making a lot of blunders in the name of preachers.
I know so many of them. And then they stand to speak. There's no word in them. They only offend people.
You have to have adequate knowledge. And this knowledge is of the will of God. And now if it is the will of God, it means the remaining three knowledge. You know the knowledges we spoke about here? We talked about gnosis. We talked about gnosko, eido, epignosis. We are talking about the will of God is of the three. The gnosko, the eido, and the... If you don't understand, I have... The book is here, please. I'll bring it and sell to you people so that we remove some foolishness a bit. We need to... I hope patience is reading, or you read, or you forgot. When you talk about the will of God, we're talking about gnosko, eido, and epignosis. If you don't have that book, I am bringing it at your service. You read and see. That is the knowledge he says you need to have. Not just any other knowledge. And if that knowledge is there, and then you get drunk with the Holy Spirit, you see now he draws from where you store those knowledge. When you begin speaking, he releases things and turns things around. And it's no longer you who is in charge, but the Holy Spirit. But the Holy Spirit. So imagine every day getting drunk in the morning by the Holy Spirit. Hata ukifungua Biblia, utaanza kuona. When you begin reading the scriptures, there are things you will see. Mpaka unashangaa hii Bible nilikuwa tu nikisoma hii tu. Because somebody who's blind has been looking at it. But when the Holy Spirit begins enlightening you, our existence should be for the revival of the people around us. The revival of churches, the revival of towns that are all over this place. You know, when we talk about reviving by the ability of the Spirit, we are talking about displacing everything that has not been founded on the Word of God. You displace. You displace. You displace. You get ability to displace. Aye? Very powerful. Displace everything that is not of God in your environment. That is when you know you're the only king in the area. Are we the only king, really? Our wealth should also determine that. Praise the Lord. Can you say millions? Just say millions. Will be accumulated in my account. In Jesus' name. I want to give you a revelation. Whenever you take out a hundredth, a thousand... Just see it as a million, eh? Then count it as a million. 1 million, 2 million. So if you see just 1,000, just see it as a million. Just add 2, 3 zeros spiritually and begin counting. 1 million, 2 million, 3 million. If there are 5,000 in your account, convert it into million. Just call it 5 million. You don't believe what I'm saying. Like us, we already have 340,000 in the bank right now. Now that is how many millions? 300 million. That is 300 million. That account was empty some 2 weeks ago. It is now 340 millions. Now I am seeing 300 million. That means I can put up a gorofa in this town. I just need 100 million. Is that true? Yes, 1 million, 100 million is even much. This one is around 30 or 40, 50 million. So I can now build a gorofa. What do you think? Stop looking at that 1,000 that you have and begin praying, God, have mercy on me. No, we just... Even in the area of finances, we need to have the understanding of the will of God.
And that is what I'm speaking about today. I want to show people how when God talks about money, he talks about not even million. In fact, God does not know this language of millions and billions and trillions. This is too small for him. We are defining God with our own words. And then we are limiting God. We should not. Prepare to receive as much money as possible. If 100 million hit your account, you don't get shocked. Kuna wale wanapoteza network, pesa ikiingia kwa account yao. Mpaka hiyo pesa ishe, hana amani. Kuna watu kama hao sio? You know those kind of people? May God help us who live by salary. You know when the salary hits there, you are excited just like mtu mwenye amelewa. Then unamaliza your salary within some few days. You go back to the normal kind of life. The normal kind of life. Then inafika tarehe 20, mwezi iko kona. Hey, that's not our lifestyle. May God revive your finances in Jesus' name. This is the year that, you know, if we are to buy land, we must have enough money. If we have to have Land Cruiser, in fact, we have it. Lie gave me 3 months. Something will happen. He says, 3 months from now. When I tell you in 1 month's time there's a million in my account, you don't be surprised, because I know what the prophet has said. And I don't care where it comes from, but I just want to see it in the account. That is all. Who brings it? Whatever, me, I don't care. What I want is, when you put a seed in the ground, you might understand how the rain has came, it germinated. But this one is a bit unique. You plant and you wait. It comes from anywhere. And just, bah! Like this week now, when I just went on Tuesday and I found 40K in the account, I didn't know. So I'm asking this guy, who put it this? And then I saw the name. Says, well, we didn't talk to him to bring money. If God has commanded him to bring money, do I have a problem with that? So I need two. So the revival of money must be there. I don't know why I want to speak money this month. The next 1 month is money. Abraham, thank God you're here. You need to hear this sermon for the next 4 days, for 4 weeks. The Bible says, faith comes by, and hearing by the word of God. And even hearing is by the word, not... Faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word. You hear by the word. That is another revelation we'll speak next time. Hearing by the word. In other words, you are to listen like God. Well, there's a way to listen like a human being, but there's a way to listen like God, so that you hear everything the way God understands. That is when your humanity will be brought to an end and you're enthroned as a God. Father, we bless your holy name for your word. Makopo de mosibi gradia. Lentoro bodiga shiri plakradiga seketere gladia. Makatere belebrose mpora basherebe gladia. Rikomo de go sekepira gladia. Lentoro bodimo shiri be gladia. I give you praise. La kaparaba de mosibi gradia. Thank you. Thank you for revival. We are reviving this county. We are revivals that revive others. Le maradima sebe krodia. We are reviving every church in this county. In the name of Jesus Christ. We are reviving. Lentaka parabademo sebe krodia. La koraba shantere beglibra seke perekledia. Robo do goso poribi klara ba shantere beglibra sebe krada. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Lentoro bodi mosibi gradia. Shaporo gloko toro boglibro sepere gladia. Amen. We give you praise. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.